So what is binary number system? And why is it so famous? Long ago, when civilization probably started, we humans discovered a number system that would have exactly 10 digits. And this number system was called the decimal number system. And the digits in this number system would be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Not so long ago, another number system became famous as the language of computers. And this was called the binary number system. A binary number system would have only two digits, 0 and 1. If a number system has n digits, we say that the base of the number system is n. So decimal number system can also be called base 10 number system. And similarly, binary number system can also be called base 2 number system. Now, why does a computer understand binary? And the simplest explanation can be that a computer is an electrical device, and all an electrical device understands is electrical signals. So say, for example, if we have an input wire to this machine, there are only two states possible for this wire. Either current is flowing through this wire or current is not flowing through this wire. If current is flowing through this wire, we say that the state of this wire or this input is signaled, and we say that a signal state corresponds to 1. And if current is not flowing, this is not signaled, and we say that not signaled state corresponds to a 0. So a 0 or 1 in binary actually translates to a signaled or non-signaled state in an electrical device. And we can have multiple wires or multiple inputs to represent multiple ones and zeros. Now let us quickly see how we write a number in these two number systems. If we write a number in decimal number system, and if we go back to our elementary school mathematics, then we write a number in one row and multiple columns. The rightmost column, or the corresponding to the rightmost digit, is called the ones place. The second right column is called the tens place. And we go on increasing in multiple of tens, like hundreds place and thousands place and so on. If we have to represent this in powers of 10, then the rightmost place, or the least significant digit, corresponds to 10 to the power 0, and go on like 10 to the power 1, 10 to the power 2, 10 to the power 3, and so on. And as we go on towards left, we go on increasing in power of tens. Say, for example, if we write a number 125 in decimal number system, we say that this number has got 5 ones, 2 tens, and 100. We could also say that this number has got 5 10 to the power zeros, 2 10 to the power 1, and 1 10 to the power 2. And this sums up to 125. Now, when we write a number in binary number system, the only digits possible are 0 and 1. The rightmost column corresponds to the 1's position. The second right column corresponds to 2's position. And we go on increasing in powers of 2, like 4's position, 8's position, and so on. And if we have to write the same thing in powers of 2's, this corresponds to 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, and so on. And similarly, we can go on, we can keep going towards left in powers of 2. Now let us write a number in binary. So let's say we pick up a number 111101. So we say that this has got 1 1 0 2's, 1 4, and we could also say that this has got 1 2 to the power 0, 0 2 to the power 1, and 1 2 to the power 2. And we can go on. So to find out the place value of a digit in binary number system, we multiply the digit 1 or 0 by the corresponding power of 2. So if we pick up the seventh column from left, then the place value here is calculated by multiplying the number 1 with 2 to the power 6. So we get this. So if we want to convert a number from binary to decimal number system, it is pretty straightforward. All you need to do is pick up all these place values and sum them up. And if you try to sum this up, this comes as 125. So 111101 in binary is actually number 125 in decimal number system. So we say that this number 1111101 in base 2 is actually 125 in base 10. Now, in this lesson, we did not describe how we got this number 1111101 in binary for 125. We will do it in the next lesson. So in the next lesson, we will show you how to convert a number from decimal number system to binary number system. So thanks for watching.